What's up? I am Bethany Angel and I make random videos, okay? So I'm going to make a video right now about having guy friends, okay? When you're a girl. Now, I have always been one of those girls that only get along. Sorry, my stomach. Who only get along with girls that don't get along with girls. I know that sounds weird, but if you're a girl, you understand what I mean by that, okay? Literally, I am a tomboy. I only hung out with guys, mainly. I would have a couple girlfriends, and that was it. And I still do. I still feel like I have more guy friends than I do girlfriends, maybe. I'm not sure. But regardless, like, I have to keep, they keep going more and more away, and it sucks, but it is what it is. So I want to talk about when you're in a relationship and you have a boyfriend and you have guy friends, okay? If you have guy friends that you have either done something with in the past, or you have dated, or you know that they like you, or they've expressed to you that they like you, especially when you're with your boyfriend, you shouldn't be friends with them, okay? I'm not saying, like, totally not be friends with them whatsoever, but, like, not really have contact as much with them, I feel, even if your boyfriend, like, doesn't care. I mean, also, if your boyfriend doesn't care because they don't know that the kid likes you, okay? So, the reason why I say this is because I would rather be with the person that I love and make them happy, because I plan on being with them for the rest of my life, and I plan to have a family with them and everything like that. And if it makes them feel uncomfortable or whatever, like, I'm not gonna be like, oh, they're just my friend, like, da da da. Like, yeah, especially when I know they like me, it's like, yeah, no. So recently, I've always had guy friends, and then they would find out that I don't want to be with them, or they would find out, like, they had no chance or something like that, and then all of a sudden they just vanish, like, they're not my friend anymore, and I'll be, like, trying to get a hold of them, being like, you know, like, what happened, and they're just kind of like, either never answer me ever again, change their phone number, or will be like, you know, I just can't be friends with you because it's too hard, you know, I can't be friends with you because it's too hard for me to watch you be with somebody else, or it's too hard for me to know, like, there could never be something between us because, like, at least before, like, there was hope because they didn't know, you know? So it's like, you have that situation. Now, when I was younger, again, I had all guy friends. So when I met my son's father, I was 19 years old. And I was pretty much like that girl that was like, well, that girlfriend that was like, no, they're just my friend, da da da. But I probably would have, I already like fucked them or something. You know what I mean? Like a long time ago. So it's like, I wasn't, I don't know. It's some weird thing. It's like, I would never cheat on my boyfriend, but like, I don't know if it's like a rebellion thing, like, cause you don't want somebody telling you like what to do kind of thing. If you just have a friend that's a guy and they don't like you, they don't act like they like you, they don't, you've never slept with them, you've never dated them, they don't make moves on you, that I would be like, okay, if my boyfriend told me I couldn't be friends with this person, I'd be like, no, like, this is ridiculous. And I would, like, fight for that person and, like, really, you know, whatever. But if, you know, you have somebody that, whatever, it's not fair to your boyfriend, I feel like. And if it's going to cause fights, it's not worth it. It's like, who do you want to choose? Like, who do you want to, you know what I mean? So I always was like fighting for my friends with my boyfriend. And I was like, you know, my ex-boyfriend. And I was always like, you know, why does it matter? Da, da, da. I don't know why it's such a big deal. And again, I don't know if it was like a rebellion thing, or if it was like a, you can't tell me what to do, or, you know, all of that. But then, you know, I got manipulated into the narcissist empath relationship, and I started doing everything pretty much that he said to do. So I wouldn't talk to anybody, like none of my friends, not even girls. So that happened. But I've had guys recently that like have told me that they liked me, and I wasn't with my boyfriend yet. And I think God is literally like kind of like bringing all of them up to like discard. And I don't mean discard as in like to let them go. To let them go, let them do their own thing, let them be themselves and like not worry about if I have a boyfriend or if they're gonna get hurt or, you know, any of that stuff. It's like I told literally everybody, like, I can't guarantee that I'm not gonna go back to my ex if, you know, he comes back. So I really don't want to be with anybody and put them through that hurt because I knew he was coming back. Like, that's the thing. I was like, I knew he was coming back. And some kid was like, oh, yeah, we'll hang out next weekend. And I'm like, no, we won't because I know he's coming back. And was it Thursday, Wednesday? He messaged me and come back. Like, I knew it. Like, I just knew it. I don't know. I even told my therapist, I was like, he's gonna come this weekend. Like, she's like, how do you know that? And I'm like, I don't know. I just do. I just have a feeling that I'm gonna be seeing him this weekend. And now he's moving in with me. But that's a whole nother story, for another day or never. But like they started like just leaving, you know? And then the ones that used to hit on me, I pretty much was like, you know, I can't have you. Like, I would use this kid, my boyfriend, as an excuse all the time. Like, you know, I can't do anything with you because, you know, I have a boyfriend. And so, like, this time when something happened, I was like, yo, like, I really actually have a boyfriend. I was like, all those other times, I just wanted you to leave me alone. Like, this time I actually have a boyfriend. And this would be the time that, if anything, I would not do anything. And, you know, I have the friends that respect me. And I have their friends that don't look at me as just a fuck and, you know, all that stuff. And it's like, it's different when you tell your boyfriend. This is for both sides too. I mean, actually, I don't know. I feel like it's a little different for guys with their girlfriends, but with girls and their guy friends, you have to also like trust your partner. 'Cause it's not just about like, it's about trust too. Like, if you don't trust that your partner is going to do the right thing in a situation that they might get caught up in, then that's another thing like that you have to work on. It's an insecurity within yourself, and it's not okay for the other person to be affected by that because they could like have not done absolutely anything, and it's like, and now they're already getting like accused of something that they didn't do, you know? So it's really weird how things like that are all put together. But yeah, I don't know. I wanted to say that this doesn't really sound like I really wanted to have the way I wanted it to come out either, but it's okay. I'm just gonna post this anyways. And then just gonna post this anyways. I just don't think it's okay to have a guy friend that likes you. You've already dated, like an ex-boyfriend. You've fucked. Under certain circumstances, like if they're like, I don't know, I want to say if they're like your best friend and like, you know, it was just like a one night stand type thing and it was only one time. I don't know. I don't know how I'd feel about that. I just wouldn't like, or like at least see how it affects the relationship or you and that person's relationship. But people have just been leaving. And I told everybody so they wouldn't get hurt, you know? But I don't know. I gotta go walk my dog. And then I gotta go shoot balls at the driving range. And my heels. See? Got my heels. My heels. Gonna play golf in my heels. All right. I'll talk to you guys later. Bye. It really sucks though because you can have really like good friends, and then all of a sudden, because they start liking you, like you can't have guy friends if you're a girl. If you're a girl and like you're a certain type of way, and a lot of guys like you from like that, and you don't understand why, and you're not trying to like lead them on or have them like you or anything like that, and you're just being you, like it sucks because like then you can't even be friends with any guys because it's like they just start liking you. And unless you want to like them back, and you don't have a boyfriend, like that's different. But like it just sucks. Like, 'cause I can hang out with girls now, but like I don't like the gossiping. I don't like the complaining. I don't like certain ways that people talk about their kids. I don't like certain talks. Like, I can't have a deep conversation with some of my friends or most women. No, that's not true, because I don't have that many girlfriends. The girls that I have that are my friends, I can have deep conversations with. I can have one-on-one conversations with that are like meaningful and personal and sentimental, you know? And I got four girlfriends that I can do that with. I feel like I'm always forgetting somebody. I can do five. I could do five, I think. Again, I don't. Jess, Ashley, Michaela. I feel like there's another person, but I feel like I would know because I would talk to them. But I don't know. I get along better with guys because they're more easygoing. Plus, I like playing sports. I just like doing stuff like that. So, but then it sucks because then they end up liking you, especially if like you're amazing and you're fun and you're spunky and like they just like you. Like, it's just, you can't help it. Like I said, I've never really gotten along with girls. Actually, you know what? It's not get along with girls. It's more they can get jealous and judgmental as well. And they always think that you're trying to steal. Well, they don't always. They can think that you're trying to steal their boyfriend, or they get jealous, or they get envious, or then they start talking shit about you and telling people. Like, girls are just harder to trust if they're not mature than men are. Because men, like, they're not going to go around telling your freaking secrets. Like, why would they? Like, I mean, they do. I'm saying some guys haven't done that. But again, like, I'm talking about mature adults. I'm not talking about the ones that just. I don't know. It just sucks. Like, I'm just saying, like, if you are a girl and you have guy friends, if your boyfriend doesn't care and trust you and it works out, that's awesome. Good for you. But I still don't think it's okay to have guys that like you if you're in a relationship, regardless. Because it can always cause problems at the end of the day. Like, at the end of the day, it can cause problems, and it most likely will, because, you know, like that music video, the Demi Lovato thing, the Tell Me That You Love Me, how, like, she has one of her best friends at 2 in the morning, like, messaging her, and he's, like, getting pissed off, and she's like, he's just my friend, what's the big deal? And then, like, they go out somewhere, and, like, he just, like, looks at a girl a certain way, and she's, like, bitching, and he's like, well, maybe I should get her number and have her message me at, you know, 3 a.m. or whatever. And she's just like, you know. So it's like, it can always be shoved in your face. I don't think it's worth it. So that is my video, unless something else comes up and I can add it. But as of right now, this is all, folks. That's all, folks. That rooster guy. I had to do a commercial, and I was him in 4th grade. I had to be the first person in the commercial, and we made Looney Tunes Junior Vitamins, right? So we had to go to like this thing. We were hiding underneath it. It was like one of those long, like, table type things that, like, you speak on, like, that has a little microphone. Like, if you were like the president, you had to like speak on it, announce or something. I don't know what it's called. Or like if you were like super, wow, valedictorian, and you had to like make a speech like before graduation, like on that pedestal type thing. So we were underneath there and we were like hiding, and then I would pop up. And I'd be the guy, and I'd be a Looney Tunes Junior Vitamins, and then I'd go back down, and then they would, you know, do their parts, and then at the end I'd go, "That's all, folks. Have a good night." I don't know. just came to me. But have a good day, guys.